Okay, hello and welcome everyone to another mnemonic session for you guys. For everyone who's coming to this class for the first time, my name is Dr. Janvi S. Bajaj and I am the Unacademy Educator for Anesthesiology. Now, it is my passion to make preparation for all your entrance exams easy for you guys, and that's why I have been coming up with this mnemonic series, and I have been taking a lot of mnemonics. You can go on to the Unacademy NEET PG channel and check my mnemonics on all important topics in NEET PG, not just anesthesia but other subjects too. So welcome to today's class. We are going to be discussing mnemonics for STI kits and their colors, so sexually transmitted diseases and the kits that are used for them, how to remember the colors of the kits as per the disease. So before we begin today's session, I want to introduce you to this amazing platform called Unacademy, which is India's largest learning platform for cracking NEET PG. Now you may ask, why should we join this platform? What is so great in it? So let me tell you guys that we have daily live classes over here of all 19 subjects. Your tests and quizzes are also absolutely live, and to gain the benefit of all of this, you just need a single subscription which will give you unlimited access to all 19 subjects. And we've also come up with an amazing iconic subscription that is to get the best of Unacademy along with Prep Ladder. So you have the live classes of Unacademy and the question bank and recorded lectures of Prep Ladder. So that way you're going to be able to get the benefit of two in just a single subscription. Now along with that, we have also come up with these test sessions for you guys, which is every day at 8 PM and 9 PM. So we have the T20 test, which has just 20 questions for the ones attempting NEET PG 2021, and we have the T20 test for those attempting NEET PG 2022 at 9 PM every day. Along with this, I'm taking a lot of free classes which is available for all of you on Unacademy NEET PG. So I urge everyone to come there. I am taking anesthesia revision courses as well. And right now it is going to be for the FMG batch, which is going to give the exam in December, and I've already taken a course for INICET on last minute revision for anesthesia. And to get all this, you just need to press one button on either your iOS or your Android app store and download the Unacademy app. Okay, so let's begin with our mnemonic for STI kits and colors. As usual, we always begin with a question. So the straight off question for you guys, which comes from this topic, is which color STI kit should be provided for lower abdominal pain? So is it the red colored kit, gray colored kit, green colored kit, or yellow colored kit? So I want you guys to answer in the chat box. I am able to see your answers over there, and tell me which color STI kit should be provided when someone comes with lower abdominal pain. Okay, even if you are unsure about the answer, go ahead and attempt it. This is the place where we will make mistakes about the same, and this is a good time for you to attempt this question. All right, so the correct answer for this is yellow kit. So whenever we are considering lower abdominal pain, we think of pelvic inflammatory diseases, and the medications that we want to give for that is contained in the yellow kit. Now you may ask me, where is the table? So this is a table that you need to remember for your exam. Your next question is going to be, how do I remember this table? For urethral discharge, anorectal discharge, it's a gray colored kit. Genital ulcer, it is a blue colored kit. How do I remember this? Okay, so now what I want to tell you guys is you just need to listen to it till the end of this, and you will not forget it at all, which colored kit is for what kind of discharge. Okay, so let's go on with our first kit. The first kit that we have is the gray kit. So when we talk about gray, what I want you guys to remember from that is gray hair. So who has gray hair? Gray hair is seen in old people, and what are old people prone to? So you know that old people have a lot of bowel and bladder problems. They are often unable to control their bowel and bladder. As a result of this, you will see that they have incontinence of bowel bladder. So incontinence of bowel and bladder will present as what? So it may present as urethral discharge. That's how we'll remember it, okay? Incontinence of bladder will give you urethral discharge, and incontinence of bowel will give you anorectal discharge, okay? So for urethral discharge and anorectal discharge, what colored kit should you be looking for? What colored STI kit? It is the gray colored STI kit. So please remember it. Old patients, gray colored hair, they have bowel bladder issues. So from bowel bladder issues, we'll remember urethral discharge and anorectal discharge. And for these kind of discharges, the kind of kit that we will be looking for is the gray kit. Awesome. Now for the next one is our green kit. Okay, so we are going to look at green kit now. So for green kit, you have to remember that there is a very famous brand of sanitary napkins. So this famous brand of sanitary napkins, it has a green colored box, okay? So you have to remember from that. Now why do we need sanitary napkins? It is for absorbing vaginal discharge or the blood that is produced during menstruation, okay? So vaginal discharge and the blood that is produced during menstruation, that is how you will remember it. It's coming from the vagina. So for that we use sanitary napkins, and especially of a brand which has a very famous brand which has a green colored packet. So for vaginal discharge, the kind of kit that you will look for, STI kit that you look for, is the green kit. Now there is one more way to remember this. It is that sanitary napkins are non-biodegradable, most of them, okay? So what they do is that they add to environmental pollution. And whenever we are talking about environmental pollution, we say that they are not green in nature, they do not add to making the environment safer. So that is another way of remembering it, but I like to remember it in this way, that the famous brand of sanitary napkins has a green colored packet. And what is sanitary napkins used for? It's for menstrual discharge, which is a form of vaginal discharge. So I will remember that for vaginal discharge I need a green kit. Okay, next one. So next one we have the kits for genital ulcer diseases. Okay, now you have to remember that genital ulcers are of two types. They are herpetic and non-herpetic ulcers. So first one, we are going to go for non-herpetic genital ulcers. Okay, now here I just want you guys to remember that how does an ulcer which is non-herpetic look like? A normal ulcer, you may have a normal aphthous ulcer in your mouth, and that looks like a white dot most of the times. Okay, so this is a normal non-herpetic ulcer. It looks whitish in color. So remember that a white colored kit is for non-herpetic genital ulcers. Okay, so how does a non-herpetic ulcer look? It is whitish in color, it is a white dot. So from that we'll remember that non-herpetic genital ulcers, the STI kit color is white. Okay, now the next one, what about herpetic ulcers? So you know that whenever a person gets herpes, it is painful, it is red in color, it is angry, and it comes with a lot of pain along with it. Okay, so your herpetic ulcers are reddish in color, that's how you'll remember it. And that's why the kit that we use for genital herpetic ulcers has to be red in color. Okay, so remember, for the non-herpetic ulcers, white color kit, because a normal ulcer looks whitish in color. And for herpetic ulcers, we'll remember it is a red color angry ulcer. I know they are in the form of vesicles, but just for the sake of remembering, remember that there is angry red herpes ulcer which is causing a lot of pain and burning to the patient. And that's how you remember herpetic ulcers will require a red colored kit. So here we have finished two types of kits, okay? For genital ulcer disease, non-herpetic, white kit. And for genital ulcer disease, herpetic, it is red kit. But now, one thing that you guys have to remember is that for patients who are allergic to penicillin with a non-herpetic ulcer, we will be using a blue kit. Okay, so that is the one thing that you will have to remember, which I don't have a mnemonic for over here. It would be amazing if one of you could come up with a mnemonic for that and write it in the chat box. But remember, if your patient is allergic to penicillin and you cannot use the white kit, then the kit that you will use is the blue kit. Okay, now the next one we have is for lower abdominal pain. Now, what does your lower abdomen have? Your lower abdomen in females, so let's stick to females over here, they basically have the uterus, and then from the uterus you have the fallopian tubes, sorry for my horrible drawing, and then at the end you have your ovaries. Okay, now what do these ovaries produce? They produce ovum, or ovum are also called as eggs, and eggs are yellow in color. Okay, so from that we will remember that any kind of lower abdominal pain where you have your ovary which is producing the ovum or eggs, you will look for a yellow kit. And remember that this lower abdominal pain mostly is the inference for a pelvic inflammatory disease. Okay, now moving on to our next kit. So we've also finished the yellow kit, and our last kit is the black kit. So how do you remember this black kit? Now the black kit is for inguinal bubo. So we'll take this word bubo from it, and we will coin a new word, bubonic plague. Okay, now you know that bubonic plague was one of the horrible diseases caused by Yersinia pestis, and because of this disease there was a pandemic called as the pandemic of black death, or it was also called as the black pandemic. Why? Because a lot of people lost their lives during this pandemic, and as a result of this it was called as the black pandemic. So from this we will remember that inguinal bubo, say we'll remember bubonic plague. From bubonic plague we'll remember that it was also called a pandemic, which was called as the black pandemic. So indirectly you have to remember that for inguinal bubo, the color of kit that you look for is the black kit. Okay, so we've discussed all the STI kits that are possible, your gray kit for urethral or anorectal discharge, your green kit for vaginal discharge, your white kit for genital non-herpetic ulcer, red kit for genital herpetic ulcer, blue for somewhere in between, yellow kit for lower abdominal pain, and black kit for inguinal bubo. So I really hope that these colors of kits, STI kits, will stick to you guys forever and you will never never forget them and mark all the correct answers in your exam. So everyone who loved this video, I would love to have you on the Unacademy app. If you would like to join me there, see more such mnemonic sessions, case based scenario discussion, image based questions, and of course anesthesia in detail, this is my referral code Dr. Janvi-YT. Join for a month and see, you will love Unacademy because we have many such innovative and creative teachers and who are dedicated and making life easy for you. So with this code you will get a 10% off on your subscription. Thank you so much for joining me today guys, and I will see you next time.